Hey everyone, so I've been debating on whether or not to put this guide out for a while, on how to collect green insignias to help you upgrade to your legendary insignias. As you know, the mod 16 changes made the green insignias, which used to be worthless, hold some value. And you know, the markets shift based on how many people were hoarding them, which ones were best, so there's a lot of uncertainty whether or not green insignias would be good in the long term, or if it was just a short-term boost. But in the end, I decided to put this information out here. And the real only trick is to use skill kits, right? The skill kit mechanic, where they're placed throughout Neverwinter, is you basically interact and you have a chance to get free insignias. So my favorite place to do this is actually in this zone in the Phantasmal Fortress, because the skill kits don't go on cooldown. If you do it out in the open world enough, eventually they'll stop paying out. If you don't know how to interact with skill kits, you have one type of kit that you get naturally from your class. Otherwise, you buy them, from NPCs. They're sold in the middle of Protector's Enclave, where all the merchants are, and you can get decent rewards. So I haven't done a ton of testing of this in mod 16, but I ran a lot of this pre-mod 16, where I believe Vigor was, and so was Leeching, still in the loot tables. I don't think they're still in the loot tables anymore. So basically, you could trade those in for green insignias of dominance, which were about 40k each. You also have a chance at purple enchanting stones here, what used to be called a superior enchanting stone. On Xbox, those have held value pretty good. Again, it used to be kind of a worthless item. They used to be around 3k each, I don't know, a year ago. But they've shot up. They've been at 20k each or more for several months now. And you can get those out of here too. So the real question is, there was a Barb Insignia skill that's like 8,000 value. Now these mount insignias are account bound, but when you basically use them as part of the upgrading process, you get an unbound insignia. So it's kind of value just for your character, but you get added value out of the insignias, which you can use in the upgrading process. You have a left chest here, which can be used to get those purple superior enchanting stones around 20k value. You'll get that chest every time you use a key. The right chest is only if you get a gauntlet. In this run, I got a mark of potency. It's about 18k value. It's not bad for considering how short it is, time-wise. So the only other thing I really want to cover is how you actually get in here. If you want to run this multiple times, you can buy keys to enter these zones from the campaign store for Dreadring, and they cost 10 scripts each, 10 Thane scripts or whatever they're called. So you can keep running it as many scripts as you have. When you complete it, you get some amount of scripts back. And the way these little mini layers function is they're on basically a weekly schedule. So I only run them on the weekends because that's when the superior enchanting stone, the purple one, drops, because that has good value to it. And again, that's always going to be, you're always going to have access to that left chest where it drops. It's a potential drop. You could get a green or a blue one, but that's the way I run it. You can take advantage of double enchanting stones for better chances, more black pearls. The first run I showed was on the end of double enchanting stones, so I was getting double black pearls. You can also do double campaign currency because, again, when you open the chest, you're going to get some amount of scripts back, so you get some bonus campaign currency too. So, how you want to run it, if you want to just do your daily, a lot of people forget about these types of zones because they're so old, or they never really interacted with them, or they bought a campaign completion. And again, the value used to be bad, but the value's gotten better with the mod 16 changes. So, I just wanted to bring this to people's attention.